Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about template-driven forms. Template-driven forms in Angular simplify user input handling with direct links between the HTML form and the data model, using directives like ng model for two-way data binding and are ideal for basic forms. And this is our HTML form which I have created already. Now what I want actually, I want to attach Angular template-driven form with this HTML form so that I can submit the values of these fields, first name, last name, email and contact. And this is our HTML which we actually want to convert into our template driven form. And for the creation of template form, first I need to go to the app.module.ts file and I need to import the forms module. Next we need to go to the app.component.ts file and we need to create our model, and then we will bind our model with the template form. And our model name will be student, and in this I need to write these fields: first name, last name, email and contact, and this is our form model. Then I need a result in which I will store these all the values, and currently it's empty. Next I need to bind this form with my HTML. For that we will use ng model in our HTML file, and this is the way we need to write this ng model: equal student dot first name. Now actually it's representing our model exactly like this. I need to write the student dot last name, then student dot email and student.contact. Actually this ng model is giving two-way binding between the front end and the back end. Next I'm going to write a function on the submit button, and on click I want to call this function on submit. On submit, what we actually want to do, we want to display our result, our values on front end. And for that I'm going to save this student object in this result. This.result is equal to json.stringify, and in this I'm going to pass this.student, and in this case it will show all the values of the student in the form of JSON on the front end. And now if I want to show this values in the form of JSON on front end, then I need to write it in our HTML file. In double curly braces I'm going to write this.result, and it will display the values on the front end. Now let's run the application and see the results on the front end. First I'm going to pressing the submit button, and for now I haven't passed any value in these fields. As you can see, all the values like first name, last name, email and contact, all the values are empty. Now let's submit the form after passing few values. And in first name I'm going to pass John, for last name it will be Vic4, and email is john@gmail.com, and contact is 4302843. And now on submit I get all the updated values. And this was the template form which used two-way data binding to update the data model in the component as changes are made in the template and vice versa. Now if we talk about the pros of the template form, then first is simplicity. They are straightforward to use, especially for simple scenarios and small forms. Second, it's suitable for basic forms. If your application doesn't require complex forms and validations, then template-driven forms might be a good choice. Third is less boilerplate. You don't need to create instances in the component class for each form control. And fourth one is two-way data binding. They make use of ng model for easy two-way data binding. And last is easier to understand. Since the form model is defined in the template, it can be easier to see the structure of the form at a glance. Next, if we talk about the cons of the template forms, then first one is scalability. Template-driven forms might become unmanageable with complex scenarios or large forms. Second is less flexibility. They offer less flexibility compared to the reactive forms, and custom validation can be tricky to implement. Third is unit testing. They are less amenable to unit testing since the logic resides in the template. Fourth is dependency on the forms module. They have a dependency on forms module which needs to be imported in every module where we want to use template-driven forms. And last is limited access to form control object. Template-driven forms do not provide easy access to the underlying form control object, which can limit their usefulness in more advanced scenarios. And this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand the template-driven forms. But still, if you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. And guys, if this lecture is helpful for you, then please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.